It's your boy Nirgun in the house, back with another bang on video. Well, yes, the live was lit, guys. You helped me reach 200 likes. It was unbelievable. And I think as I last saw, I guess 101 subscribers away from reaching 10k. I think we're not far off. Let's see if we can reach it, reach the milestone by tomorrow. But let's see. Moving on, let's just jump into the Felipe Coutinho news. John Barnes thinks Felipe Coutinho should join Arsenal as they are the best fit for him. Barnes says, I don't think Tottenham would be interested, as I don't know if the way that Jose likes to play will suit him, as he likes the ball and having a lot of possession, whereas Mourinho doesn't necessarily play that way. Arsenal could be the best club with the style of football they play. Chelsea could be another good match because of the way Frank Lampard sets up the team. So with that in mind, Arsenal-Chelsea would be the best solution for him. But Felipe Coutinho has not thought about his future despite links with Arsenal. Well, he had an interaction with Esporte Interativo. He said, my mind is fully focused on the competition. It's a very unique opportunity for us. I am very happy to be in the Champions League final. On my future, I haven't thought of it about it because I'm only thinking about the final. Well, yes, he's given his verdict, but let's talk about the Brazilian's move to Nou Camp has failed to prove a success since his transfer from Liverpool in 2018. And since now Ronald Koeman is expected to be announced as Barcelona's new manager, well, it looks like in 2017, the ex-Everton boss said something good about Felipe Coutinho. He says he's a great player and I think he could be very useful to Barcelona, but he's a great player with a lot of qualities without any doubt. So this is what actually Ronald Koeman said back in the day about Felipe Coutinho. And let's see, but there are lots of casualties that Barcelona will look at right now. But at the moment, as things stand, Felipe Coutinho is razor sharp focus on his Champions League campaign. But according to Sammy Mokbo, he says there is also some truth in links between Arsenal and Coutinho. A transfer could materialize before the end of the transfer window. So it looks like Arsenal are dang interested in Felipe Coutinho. You just have to wait and watch and just see how this transfer window actually plays out. Will Arsenal actually get Felipe Coutinho? Let's delve into another report which suggests what are the transfer targets for Ronald Koeman. AS actually report that there are three main players that Barcelona's newest manager is targeting. Number one on that list is a striker in Lautaro Martinez, who is obviously the name at the top of the list. Unless Barcelona can make Luis Suarez 4 years younger, that is what they posted. Also, the other two players that they're looking at are Manchester City's Eric Garcia and Ajax's Van de Beek. It remains to be seen if Koeman's hiring increases any more flexibility in the transfer budget this summer, but it looks like how things will turn out. I think these are the three players, and also the fourth player that is being linked is Ronald Koeman wants Jorginho Wijnaldum at Barcelona. Well, yes, according to certain reports, Jorginho Wijnaldum is wanted at Barcelona, which suggests that Felipe Coutinho may not have a future at Barcelona. He could be loaned off, or probably they want him to be offloaded as well. Well, let's talk about this thing. So this is everything that I know about Felipe Coutinho. Let's wait for his Champions League campaign to get over. As an Arsenal fan, I would really have no problem in waiting and analyzing how things will turn out with Felipe Coutinho, but let's see. I'm pretty much hopeful that it could happen, but let's see. I would want to know what happens with Aouar and Ceballos as well. So let's see how things will turn out. Well, according to ESPN, Manchester City have approached Lyon about Hossein Aouar, sources have said ESPN, but face tough competition from Arsenal, who have already held talks with Lyon's sporting director Juninho. Lyon and Arsenal are due to talk more for the player valued around 50 million euros. So that is unbelievable, man. I personally believe that it could be happening, but let's move on. Wolves have become the latest Premier League team to register their interest in Arsenal's Ainsley Maitland-Niles. Newcastle's manager Steve Bruce is also monitoring the developments on Ainsley Maitland-Niles. Brighton were linked and so have been Tottenham. Well, Charles Watts has opened up about Hossein Aouar. He says, whether Arsenal sign him, that's something that's going to run. There's a lot of interest in him and it will be very difficult for Arsenal to get that done because of the price tag Leo want. But he's still a player Mikel Arteta really, really likes. So yes, I think Hossein Aouar to Arsenal is definitely there for the taking, man. Well, also, there was also a news which actually is not Arsenal related, but it's really huge. That local report suggested that Harry Maguire was one of the three people taken to police station in handcuffs after altercation with other Brits. And also, it is suggested that he actually hit on a police officer as well. So he's probably jailed, man. Well, moving on, Arsenal women tweeted out that there is just one day left and the Arsenal women are already at Anoeta Stadium, San Sebastian. Well, yes, they're waiting for their fixture against Paris Saint-Germain women. And yes, I will definitely come up with a preview of tomorrow's game against Arsenal versus Paris Saint-Germain women. Let's see. I hope we get it again. Well, moving on. Well, Gazzetta dello Sport report that Torreira has given the green light from Arsenal to leave the club. Many Italian teams are interested in him and looking to sign him before the window closes. So yes, it looks pretty much certain that Torreira does not find Arsenal as his parent club anymore. He doesn't want to. But here's a Jordan Knobs a quote from her interview recently. When 17-year-old Jordan Knobs first arrived at Arsenal in the summer of 2010, manager Laura Harvey handed her a bin liner containing her new kit. Knobs and Steph Houghton, who joined the club on the same day, stood next to each other as they excitedly reached into the black sacks to see what shirt numbers they'd been given. She pulled out number 2 and I pulled out number 8, recalls Knobs, smiling. It was kind of a special moment. Well, while Houghton moved on to Manchester City 3 years after that memorable day, Knobs is this month celebrating 10 years at Arsenal. So Jordan Knobs, 10 years at Arsenal, that is unfreaking believable, man. Well, introducing the new club photographer, Katie McCabb. Well, not only this, let's see, there are more. Where you can let us know what you guys think about these new photographers. Let's see, videographers, photographers, who actually, according to you, in Arsenal women's team should be appointed as an Arsenal photographer. Moving on. Well, the Independent say, now suddenly this news has come up, that Manchester United have advanced their interest in Gabriel. United renewed discussions with his representatives on Thursday, despite the Brazilian having agreed a deal with Arsenal and asked for the defender to delay his decision. Solskjaer is known to be an admirer of Gabriel, who has been a key figure for Lille this season. For now, it waits to be seen whether United's interest will translate into an official bid, with Gabriel still understood to be assessing his options. I doubt this is even true. I completely doubt this is even true, because they have one defender already jailed in Greece, man. They need to go and get them. Get him. Moving on. Well, Willian has opened up about his age being a big factor among Arsenal fans. He says, "My age is no big thing. If you look after yourself, live right and train right, today's players can still be at top level when they are 35. I have a lot to play for with Brazil too. I want to be at the next World Cup. If I do well at Arsenal, then that will happen." So yes, they are ready. Willian is ready to actually represent Brazil after, you know, trying to work wonders with Arsenal. Well, moving on. Gennaro Gattuso has spoken with Socrates on the phone. The Greek defender's contract expires in 10 months and he's trying to convince Arsenal to release him. He could sign a 2 or 3 year deal at Napoli on a lower salary than he receives at Arsenal. So let's see how things will turn out. I hope so. And there's a very funny news for you towards the end. Please wait and watch. Gabby, Arsenal actually posted an image of Gabriel Martinelli in the third away kit. He looks pretty slick, doesn't he? Well, official announcement of Oba's new contract could now run into early next week, according to Mark M. Bryans. But trust me on this, the excitement is completely gone, man. But I think 10K will be before Aubameyang signing. Well, moving on, Arsenal official statement suggests that we hope to be able to welcome supporters back to the Emirates for the Sheffield United game scheduled for 3rd of October for Saturday 3rd. We will share full information regarding fan attendance at reduced capacity matches by Wednesday 2nd of September. So it's going to be lit. Let's see how things will turn out. Well, also one more update. Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain will miss Community Shield after returning home from Austrian preseason camp with a knee injury. So there will be no Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain, man. And here's the biggest news that I would wanted to give you. After this news, I would want all the Arsenal fans who are listening to this give a very hearty laugh at it. But let's move on. According to Rise Sport, Napoli have a list of defenders they would want to go on to if they miss out on Gabriel. Do you know? There are three targets. Number one, Socrates. Hold your laughter. Number second is Mustafi. Number third is Jean-Claire Todibo. And now you can laugh. They're actually going for Socrates and Mustafi. I mean, no disrespect to Socrates or Mustafi. I would want them to be, you know, removed from the wage bill. I think they should come and actually take both of our two defenders. But trust me on this. Imagine on one day you are actually linked with Gabriel a lot, and the next day you are actually going and targeting Socrates and Mustafi in order to replace Gabriel. I mean, unbelievable. The Serie A clubs never fail to, you know, baffle me. Moving on, while talking about more stuff, well, you can actually calling all the Arsenal fans, go and vote for Vivian Medima because she has been nominated for Barclays FAWSL PFA Fans Player of the Season Award. I actually voted for Vivian Medima. Well, she has been already, you know, she's been nominated, so go and get your precious vote for this player straight away. While James Benge tweets out, Gabriel taking his time ahead of what he knows will be a defining move for his future career. Manchester United interest has developed in recent days, but Arsenal are understood to have advanced further. So there is no competition at all from Arsenal to Arsenal from Manchester United. So I don't think so there will be an issue for Arsenal. I think it's almost a done deal. I think they're just stretching this out, but problem is it is quite draining for all the Arsenal fans, so I really don't want to completely more and more report about it as well. Well, these were the news of the day. I hope you enjoyed whatever you came your way. All the views and news and everything about Arsenal comes on this platform every single day twice. So sit back, relax and enjoy all the news that comes on this platform. I will see you in my next video. Until then, cheers, and don't forget to subscribe. We are on our mission of reaching 10,000 subscribers. It is definitely not far off, because once we reach 10, we're definitely looking at 20, man, and we are not definitely going to halt or probably slow down in our progress, because I think 10k is very much soon, and I think 10k there's going to be a special live, and definitely there's going to be a special community post about it. So please guys, wait for it, and I think we can do it by tomorrow or before the Aubameyang signing. Cheers, and I will see you in my next